much walking did I do to get to a size 6? Well, first, I had to get in a calorie deficit and combine it with walking. And if you want to have an idea of how much calories you need to be in a deficit, you can check out this free website. I'm not sponsored by it, but this is what I use, tdeecalculator.net. It'll give you a basis of how many calories you need to be in a calorie deficit. But just remember, all calorie calculators, anything like the fitness apps and the calculators on the treadmills and all that stuff that are calculating calories, they're not fully accurate. So don't get stuck on it, because they all lie and make it sound like you're burning more calories than you are. So don't get too stuck on exactly hitting an amount of calories or burning a certain amount of calories. So once I got into a calorie deficit, I chose portion control at first because numbers were overwhelming to me. Then I decided to combine it with walking. I chose walking because, yes, jogging and running and HIIT training, they burn more calories, but I was 275 pounds and it was really difficult for me to keep a high intensity exercise going for a long period of time. So I decided to do walking, and I started with 15 minutes a day because that was all I could handle at my size. And I started at a size 24, 275 pounds, and I walked for 15 minutes every single day for the first 3 months. And because I had so much weight to lose, walking every day plus eating in a calorie deficit, I lost 50 pounds. Once I lost that 50 pounds, I was able to walk longer and I had so much more stamina. So I started walking for 30 to 45 minutes every single day. And I steadily lost weight because I was in a calorie deficit and I was able to walk. Now I chose low intensity, steady state cardio, again, because I was still really heavy and I could maintain walking just at a normal pace for 30 to 45 minutes after losing that first 50 pounds. So it took me, for portion control and walking every day, it took me about 2 years to lose 130 pounds. And I've kept it off for 6 years. And a few months ago, I wanted to get leaner. But basically, it's weight and distance. So if you're bigger and you have a lot of weight to lose, you're not gonna need to walk as much, which is why I only could do 15 and 30 minutes in the beginning, and I lost a lot of weight doing that. If you have a little bit of weight to lose, you're gonna have to walk longer. So now I do an hour of cardio 6 times a week, and that helps me stay lean because I didn't have much weight to lose. I got myself from a size 11 to a size 6. I started in the summer, so about 6 months, and I dropped about 20 pounds. And that was doing, again, steady state cardio, low intensity. I choose not to do the treadmill because I still have damage on my knees and my heels from when I was overweight. So if I have to do the treadmill, I do. But otherwise, I like to get outside in nature and just walk at a normal pace. Or I have a recumbent bike that I bought specifically to help my knees and my heel. And I like to do that as well. So if cardio sounds like a terrible word to you, it doesn't have to be walking or running or things that you think are cardio. Anything that gets your heart rate up for 15 minutes at least is cardio. You can clean, you can walk your dog or take your kids for a walk. You can dance, turn on some tunes and dance around. Anything where you can get your heart rate up, that's it. You can do probably this burns calories. And that's it. And as you get more fit, you're gonna be able to do more. I couldn't have done an hour of cardio a day in the beginning. And actually, what I didn't mention was, when I did the 15 minutes in the beginning, at my weight, and I had plantar fasciitis really bad, I had to stop every few minutes. So it wasn't 15 minutes of solid walking. It was 15 minutes stopping where I needed to, and then going until my 15 minutes was done. And then, like I said, as I got more fit, I was able to go longer without stopping, to where then I was able to do 45 minutes a day. Now I can do an hour and I feel really energized after. So, you know, starting small worked really well for me, and then slowly building it up as I felt more comfortable. I really enjoy cardio now. It feels like my day's not complete if I don't do it, and it helps me stay lean, and I like eating, so it works out really well. For intensity wise, I have always liked steady state, low intensity. So whatever that is for you. For me, I walk just, you know, at a normal pace. Some days, if I feel it, I go a little harder, but I don't force it.
And on the bike, do you do like high tension or low tension or?
Oh yeah. On the bike, what I like to do is I basically like to keep the pace of, I'm breathing heavy, but I can still hold a conversation. But it's kind of like, if you've ever seen me on Instagram doing cardio in my story and you hear me talking to you, you'll hear that my breath kind of catches. It's kind of heavy. That's it. I just need to be breathing heavy and still able to hold a conversation.
And
that's the intensity I like.
That's about the intensity me and Nicole have on our walks too. Like, we're always talking about video ideas and stuff on our walks. If you can talk and walk comfortably, like without being out of breath or having to stop your talking, you're in probably low intensity, steady state cardio.
Yeah, and that's about it. Like, just walking and that's about it. Still conversating. And, on the bike, like, I like to stay between 78 and 84 RPMs. I don't know if that means anything to you, but I just look at that on the bike and that's what I do. And then on the treadmill, again, if I do that, I just go where I can carry a conversation.
What about, like, do you put it on an incline or anything on the treadmill?
Yeah, I can't do too much incline because I find I have scoliosis and I find it hurts my back if I do it too high. So I do no more than 5 incline. And if I feel anything hurting, I lower it back down and I just go a little bit faster. I go like just the same always, where I'm like this. So Kyle and I both had a lot of weight to lose. We've both lost 130 pounds and we've kept it off for 6 years. We chose to lose the weight slowly. Like I said before, it took us about 2 years to lose the weight doing walking and portion control. We started 15 minutes every day for the first 3 months. Then after that, for the next year and a half, we did 20 to 45 minutes every single day. Always, like we said, steady state intense, low intensity, steady state cardio. And then for the last 6 months, I've been doing an hour a day, 6 times a week, every day except leg day. Basically, eating what I love, staying in a calorie deficit, and enjoying what I do for exercise. So choose something that you love to do and do that as much as you can. And being able to do that will help you. Cardio is good for your heart and it will help you get off the excess fat. That's what helps me stay lean, walking and loving it. So the friends, I hope you enjoy this video. Find something you love and do it up. Lawnmower it. And if you want to know exactly what Kyle and I ate to lose our first and next 50 pounds, we have 2 weight loss guides in the links down below. Exact meals, exact portions, and family-friendly recipes. It's all included. Check it out. Watch these 2 videos. Shake it, baby. Shake it.
Whoa.
And a little jiggle. Lawnmower. I'm out. Peace. Love you. Remember the friends that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here, heart and mindset. Fight through it.